Hello everyone, welcome to Aster Global School. Today we are going to start a new lesson, that is lesson number 2, Mountains and Plateaus in India. Now, in the previous chapter, we learned about maps. There are three types of map: physical, political and thematic. But today we are going to study a physical map of India, right? Why I am telling that physical map? Because here it is written that mountains and plateaus and in India, mountains and plateaus are natural resource, so they come in the physical maps. So let's see the different landforms in India. India is home to the Himalayas, one of the largest mountain ranges in the world. India is home to Himalayas, one of the largest mountain ranges in the world. The Indian people live in Himalayan region, practice different religions. This is the Buddha Park, a popular tourist attraction in Sikkim. There are famous plateaus in India too. This is the Deccan Plateau found in Maharashtra. Look, people are celebrating Ganesh Chaturthi in Maharashtra. Let's learn more about Indian landforms and its people. So on the screen you found some of the few landforms like Himalayas, Deccan Plateau, right? But there are many more things beside this also. So let's see them. Landforms of India. Our country India has various landforms that make it unique and interesting. Landforms of India can be grouped under 6 divisions. These are the Northern Mountains, the Northern Plains, the Thar Desert, the Peninsular Plateau, the Coastal Plain and the Iceland. Now these are the different landforms. Underline everyone on page number 11, the Northern Mountain, the Northern Plain, the Thar Desert, the Peninsular Plateau, the Coastal Plain and the Iceland. You can see on the map, right? So, turn your pages, page number 12. First, we'll be studying about the Northern Mountains. In the northern part of India lie the mighty Himalayas. Now you can see, right, northern part. You can see Himalayas colored in dark brown color. This is the range of Himalaya. It is a mighty mountain, means very big mountain. A long row of mountain that stretches from Jammu Kashmir in north to Arunachal Pradesh in east. Now you can see it is starting from Jammu Kashmir and ending up to Arunachal Pradesh. Along its way, it crosses Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim and the northern part of West Bengal. You can see, right, the brown color dots, they are starting from Jammu Kashmir, then Arunachal Pradesh, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim and northern part of West Bengal. After Arunachal Pradesh, it bends southward and stretches till the state of Mizoram. After Arunachal Pradesh, it bends and goes down up to Mizoram. The Himalayas are divided into 3 rows of mountain that run alongside each other, like one layer, second layer and third layer. This way the Himalayas have 3 different layers. What are they? At the top, close to China border, are great Himalayas known as Himadri. You can read, right, Himadri is written. That is the topmost layer. After that, greater Himalayas are the middle Himalayas, that are Himachal. You can read Himachal written here. Then lie the outer Himalayas, that is Shivalik range. You can see Shivalik range. So first is Himadri, then Himachal, then Shivalik. These are the 3 different ranges of Himalayan mountains. So now, first, let us read about the greater Himalayas, that is Himadri, means the topmost layer. It is the highest of three rows. Himadri is the highest of three rows. Mount Everest, the highest mountain peak in the world, is located in the greater Himalayas. Now you can see Mount Everest written. It lies in the Himadri region. Nanga Parbat, Annapurna and Kanchenjunga are the three important peaks of greater Himalayas. Now you can see, right? Kanchenjunga, Nanga Parbat and Annapurna. Now these four mountains lie in the greater Himalayas. Then the greater Himalaya range is permanently covered with snow. One more point, that the greater Himalayas or the Himadri region is permanently covered with snow. It is extremely cold and difficult to live here. It comprises of thick sheets of ice and snow which move slowly over the land, called glaciers. Often the lower portion of this glacier melt in the heat, leading to the formation of river. Many important rivers such as Ganga, Yamuna and Brahmaputra originate in this glacier. Now what happens? The ice on greater Himalayan range slowly slides down, and when it comes down, it is a bit heater than the topmost region. So what it forms? It forms rivers like Ganga, Yamuna and Brahmaputra. The Middle Himalayas or Himachal. The Middle Himalayas lies below the Greater Himalaya. Now once the layer of Greater Himalayas or Himadri is completed, then comes the Middle Himalayas or Himachal. These mountains are not as high as the Himalayas and are covered with thick vegetation of pine and deodar, tea plantation, especially in the states of Assam and West Bengal. And orchards of apple and peaches are common here. Now you can see here, this image is of the Middle Himalayas. What all is found? They are not as high as Greater Himalaya. They have pine, deodar, tea, apple, peaches. Most people here live in the beautiful hill towns that also attract many tourists during summer month, like Shimla, Nainital, Mussoorie and Darjeeling are some of the important hill stations situated in the Middle Himalayan regions. Now, comparing to Greater Himalaya, in Greater Himalaya, no one can survive because it is completely covered with snow. But in Middle Himalayas, there are many hills towns, like towns situated on hills. You can find small, small houses here, right? Now, these are also a center of attraction for tourists during summer. During summer season, it is cold here. So, many tourists come here. Now, what are some of the most important hill stations? Shimla, Nainital, Mussoorie and Darjeeling. So, next that we are going to study is the Outer Himalayas or the Shivalik Range. The Outer Himalayan Range is the lowest of the three. First is Greater Himalaya, then Middle Himalaya, then Outer Himalaya. That is Himadri, Himachal and Shivalik. The slopes of this mountain are covered with thick forest where a variety of wild animals are found. Now in first layer, nothing is found. In second layer, you can find vegetation and people. In third layer, there are thick layers of forest with wild animal like Garo, Jaintia, Khasi and Mizo hills are part of the Outer Himalaya. Which hills? Garo, Jaintia, Khasi and Mizo hills. Many people live in small villages on this mountain slope. Now here also we can find animal and people. Several type of crops such as rice and wheat and fruits such as cherries, plum, apricot are grown here in terrace farms and orchards respectively. So what all you can find? Forest, wild animal, people, rice, wheat, cherry, plum, apricot and orchards. And how they are grown? On terrace farming. Now you can see an image of terrace farming, right? Steps of layer. This is known as terrace farming. Now the life in Himalayan region. You can see a table in your book, right? It says Jammu and Kashmir, type of cloth they wear, and the crops that are grown, what do they make, what is their occupation, and what are the festivals they celebrate. This thing you have to read by your own. So, the next topic that we are going to read is importance of northern mountains. What is the importance of this range of mountain? So, number one, they do not allow the cold winds from Central Asia to enter India. Because of their height, they don't allow the cold winds to enter India. The forest of Himalayas give us wood, medicine, resins and other useful things. What do they give? Wood, medicine, resin and many useful things. Number three, the Himalayas are also known as home of God. Many pilgrimage towns such as Haridwar, Rishikesh, Hemkund Sahib and others are located here. It is also known as home of God. Many pilgrimage. Now, what do you mean by pilgrimage? Pilgrimage means temple, or in Hindi what we say tirth. Many tirth places are situated here, like Haridwar, Rishikesh, Hemkund Sahib and others. Now, another landform. We completed Himalayan region, right? Now we are going to see Peninsular Plateau. You can see the image in a slight brown and pinkish color. This region is Peninsular Plateau. It is located to the south of Northern Plains. Now after Northern Plains completed, starts the Peninsular. Both mountain and plateaus are highland, but the plateau is a type of landform that looks like a huge flat table, higher than the surrounding area, often with one or more slides with steep slopes. Now what happens? It is not as high as mountain and not as plain as a plain land. Now if you look at the map of India, you will see that the southern part of India is surrounded by water on three sides. Such a landform is called peninsula. The plateau region stretches from the central part of India to the southern tip. Now, two important points. It is surrounded on three sides by water. And the second point is, it stretches from the central part to the southern tip. It is broad towards the north and narrow towards the south. It is divided into two large parts by the river Narmada and the Deccan Plateau. In how many parts? Two parts. One, by Narmada, the central highlands, and in the north, the Deccan Plateau, in the south. So first, we'll study about the central highland. What is it? The central highland consists of two plateaus, the Malwa Plateau, the Chhotanagar Plateau. You can read on the map, see, Malwa Plateau and Chhotanagar Plateau is written in the central. So these are called central highlands. The fine black soil of the Malwa Plateau is good for growing cotton, sugar, cane and oilseed. What? Cotton, sugar cane and oil seeds. The Chota Nagpur is rich in minerals such as coal, iron, manganese, bauxite and mica. You need to underline this. What all Malwa Plateau will get? Cotton, sugar cane, oil seed and Chota Nagpur Plateau will get? Coal, iron, manganese, bauxite and mica. So next is Deccan Plateau. The Deccan Plateau is also rich in mineral. Earlier, most of the gold in India came from the Kolar gold mines in Karnataka in the Deccan Plateau. The other states that are located in the Deccan Plateau are Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. Jog Falls, the highest waterfall in India, is located in Karnataka. You can see the waterfall. It is also situated in the Deccan Plateau. So here also we'll find life in the Peninsular Plateau. The area, the main cities, the crop that they grow, they wear what type of clothes, they celebrate which festival. This is all also that you have to read on your own. Importance of Peninsular Plateau. Now we already read about importance of Himalayan region. The next we are going to read is importance of Peninsular Plateau. Number one, the plateau region is rich in mineral. It has led to the development of many industries. Before also we saw, we can find gold, iron, bauxite, mica and many more minerals. So it led to the development of industries in India. Dams. Dams built on the river of this region provide water for crops and produce electricity. Now, there are many rivers flowing in this region. What do? They help us providing electricity and water for crop. Some important crops such as cotton and oilseed grow well in the plateau region. Now, some crops like cotton and oilseed cannot be grown anywhere else rather than the plateau region. So, in this chapter, what we all learn is the landforms of India, mainly two landforms, that is the Himalayan region and the peninsular plateau. In Himalayan region, you have three layers, that is Himadri, Himachal and Shivalik, and in plateau you have two, that is number one the central highlands, number two the Deccan plateau. Hope you all understood, and if you have any doubts you can ask me. Fine everyone, bye, take care.